the internet connection at this popular caravan park is absolutely diabolical to non-existent on our cell phones. So today I'm hoping to use some of the latest tech to solve a problem and add a Wi-Fi 6 system to this caravan and receive signals from the 5G transmitter nearby. When I saw this TV aerial, it gave me some inspiration, and I'm going to be going through all the latest technology and explaining what I have learned about it. On this particular caravan, the TV aerial was moved to this location because the picture was substandard, and that has left me with a couple of bolts in it which we can utilise just to put another pole in. These poles are known as J-poles, and this one is of the 5 foot length, which is the longest one I could find on the internet, and that cost $15.79 delivered. And the plan's to connect this latest pointing 5G aerial, which I'll go into a bit later on the video, via a couple of clamps to the pole. So to connect the aerial, I've been to Screwfix and spent, I believe, £3.29 on these two clamps. Like so. One of these should connect the aerial to the pole. So when trying to connect the aerial, there's a bit of a problem here with these nuts here. They could really do with some washers on this kit, but there aren't any in it. So I've had a rummage in my toolbox, and the best I could find were a couple of fuel injection washers, which will do quite nicely. So I've nipped them up as tight as I dare, and here is the model number of the pointing aerial. So that's the antenna installed, and we're pointing it towards the nearest 5G transmitter, which is in the northwesterly direction. This aerial represents the latest tech. This unit picks up signals from more bandwidth than its predecessor, and this unit cost me £100 second hand. Normally around £150, won't be out of order. And you do get 5 meters of cable, so extenders will be the order of the day the higher you have the aerial up. So what I'm thinking about is the next challenge is to get the cable inside the static caravan. And this is the aerial cable. It's not particularly good practice to have a joint on the exterior, but it seems to be sheltered. So I'm thinking about getting something in there. So I'll just unplug the TV aerial and take this off with a screwdriver. And there we have it. I think I might have an easier time if I take the Patras box out. And now I can see how it's routed. So hopefully I'll be able to pull the aerial cable through that. Okay, this is how I've got the cable in. Bit of a risk. But this is the coax for the TV. So we attach that to some strimmer line. Pulled that out, you can see I've got like at least a good foot, possibly more. And then I pulled that back in with another length of strimmer line. And then we connected the aerial cable for the TV, the internet, and we connected the internet receiver, or aerial, with another length of it from outside. So as we pulled the aerial in, we pulled another one through, and then it's quite a lot of volume, so we just went really careful and it just kind of worked out. So now I've got the cable in and I've neatened a few things up. That's ready to connect. This router can do Wi-Fi 6, and it's a ZTE model MC801A. So I've got a SIM card, £15 a month, unlimited data from ID Mobile. And these SIMs are what are known as triple cut. So we've got the regular size SIM there, a micro SIM, right down to a nano SIM. So I found the best way to insert the SIM is with the diagonal edge chip down and give it a little push in until it feel a click.
Well, I've got this router now connected, and these are SMA connectors, so I've got two male connectors in there. And around the back of this router, I mean, there ain't too many routers you can do this with. I've got them shoved in there now. You do have to be ultra careful with that because they're mounted onto the PCB. So unfortunately, there are people who've damaged their PCB. But there ain't too many 5G routers about that will accept an aerial. And we've fiddled with the aerial outside. And there are these three lights here. These are for the signal. And we've got all three lit at the minute. Now, it does vary. It goes down to two and then even one. But that's just what happens. And we have achieved a reasonable speed. So we can now stream anything we like to keep little people happy. And even big people. And we do get speeds up to 130 megabits per second. Which I think it's pretty good. I mean, that time we took at 6:40 a.m. So it's a quiet time for the internet. And it progressively slows down to sub 50 throughout the day, we've found. Many thanks for watching, and why not subscribe?